Alright, alright. Drive shaft. She got the carrier bearing.
Ooh, all dirty.
Drive shaft complete.
Back to tarpon. We're actually strapped.
And that's what actually moves up and down and pushes on the spring. Those head bolts are probably one of the hardest things I've ever had to get out.
And a JB hook.
Oh, that was nice of you. 19765. Fleet guard. So that is a wrap. What do you think? You good?
Every state is probably going to be different.
We are heading to Florida, guys. The first way station is closed as expected because it is just a small one coming out of Greenville going into Columbia. But 50 degrees, a little chillier than what has been lately in good old Greenville. We fueled up a little bit at $3 a mile on the money, right at $3. And we'll get down to Florida tonight and be ready for the delivery tomorrow. We have an open window from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. But we'll plan accordingly, see how our clock works and get there so it works best for us. Not sure if we're gonna get something out tomorrow. If there's something late picking up in Savannah or Jacksonville. We are going down to Orlando, but the biggest thing of this load is seeing if they're going to pay that other 50%, as they said, quick pay, ACH, or I'll just take another Comcheck Express code if that's how easy it is to do. I'll rather do that, so we shall see. But right now, we're cruising hurt, we're cruising good. All the vitals look great in the truck, and yeah, can't complain. Let's get down to 95 and head south.
Stopped at the good old QT. Got a little midnight snack. Well, it's not really midnight. It's like 7:30, 8 o'clock. Got a little, this chicken, Chipotle chicken wrap, I think it's called. Pretty dang good. I like it. Haven't had it in a while. I'm hungry, but I don't want to stop at like a authentic Mexican or anything. So, one on the go. Let's get down to Florida, get this delivered, and see what happens with the other 50% of this payment.
95 is alive. Some reverse lights. Okay, they almost missed 95. Now they're jumping on 95. Let's hope that they got some giddy up because I'm gonna have to hit the jakes harder. Drop a gear. There we go. All right. There you go. It's backed up a little bit. They got 95. Southbound, we got 80 miles in South Carolina, 110 in Georgia, and we will be in our friendly state of Florida. Let's do it. I love running at night though. Or early night, it's not even 9 o'clock yet, because less traffic. We'll get through Highway 4, we'll shut it down, get some sleep, deliver in the morning, should be a quick unload, and then we will look for something out of Jacksonville or Savannah coming back, or maybe we'll get something short back where we live, which is worth more than driving 250 miles from Savannah, like we did last time. But once those Savannah lows get prevalent and back to 800, 900, then that will make it a lot more worthwhile. Just not to waste the fuel, just to bring it back. But for right now, we still got to get with the program. Let's get down to Orlando. Made it through the Savannah S-curve. Oh yeah, unscathed. Oh, man, someday they'll get this construction fixed. Pretty easy night. It's actually going up in temperature, 62 degrees. It got down to 52 for a little bit. But yeah, got some construction, so a lot of trucks on the other side of the highway, but we're smooth sailing on this side. Let's get down to Florida, guys. Got the bypass on the last Georgia way station. We're almost to Florida. Depending on what happens tomorrow, I'm going to get big old girl washed. I don't care. It's not supposed to rain so much. I don't know if that guy's just pulling in there for fun or he's going to sleep there. But, yeah, I was going to do it right now, but I just really want to make it down there and reset my clock so I can get on out but or get a split sleeper, get 7 hours. But, yeah, we're definitely going to have to get this thing washed. The big old girl has been neglected. She needs to get all pretty again. Since we got on 95, so we're about 200 miles. Let's do a little run, Find a gear. There we go. I'm not gonna get any food. Wendy's is open, but yeah. I'm not hungry. Tito's made me a nice turkey sandwich with some Bavardi cheese. That was good enough for me. Might get something like exit 305. That'll probably be my next stop once I get into Florida, and then we'll shoot across 4. Hopefully with no traffic. That would be nice. I'll turn my lights off so I'm blinding these guys. Come on through here, and I like this truck stop for an easy off and on if you're heading southbound. This is where I actually saw Deron for the first time. Deron, I hope you're doing good out there, man. I don't know if you're still watching the channel or not, but he has his pilot license out of North Carolina. He had a bunch of stuff on his plate, but he had a beautiful burnt orange W9 like mine, like matching frame and everything. I think he sold it, but I saw it at this truck stop. Awesome truck. How's this middle one looking? Can I pull through? Yes, I can. Because I don't need any fuels. There we go. Alright, let's refresh. Quiet at the pilot tonight. I wonder what truck stop I've been to the most in my life. I wonder if it's exit 60, QT, exit 21, or maybe exit 1 with the Wendy's. Who knows? Let's get back in the truck. Let's get going. Got the old call in to the way station. It's got a roll door in front of us. Turn my lights off. Stop before you get on the scale and then roll onto it nice and easy. They don't want you to be abrupt on it, because if you are, it messes up the calibration. So don't like slam on your brakes and don't abruptly pull on it, you know. Just take your time. Alright. Make sure your back tandem's good on there. There you go. Away from the light, away from the talk to you. There you go, green light. I don't know what that guy's doing walking across the walkway there, but he definitely took the whole path on the walkway. But UPS guy. I don't see a UPS truck over there though. He's got the brown outfit on though. Alright, let's cruise on down to the next way station in Daytona. And then we're cruising over to kind of between Orlando, between Tampa. This old FLD out here still making it happen. A white one right there. There you go. Some budget cords on the headlights. Heck yeah. Let's get going. Let's book it. Iconic rail bridge. There's no water under there, just a bunch of rail. And we are in Jacksonville. Bunch of cars down there to the right. Oh yeah. Coming off the ports, coming off the trains. We're gonna head over the river, St. John's River, I believe it's called, and then we'll be going through Jacksonville, heading down to Daytona. And we got a little update on our buddy Landon. If you guys never heard about Landon, his whole family, his brother, his papa's mom, dad, all got a watch channel here and there, but Landon really took a liking to the channel, and he watched it a lot while he was in the hospital. He had a pretty bad accident on Christmas Day last year, so it's almost been a year anniversary, Landon, and I'm praying for you, buddy. Your papa sent me a little email, or sent my wife, T-Dubs, an email, and we're praying for the best for you, buddy, and you're getting better, and I guess you're on a new baseball squad, too, T-Dubs told me, my wife. Are going to be starting a new team and you're a pitcher now, so that's awesome. Congratulations on that, Bubba. Let's get on through Jacksonville and go past that hospital that you were in. There's a bridge that has a hospital, children's hospital, that he had to go to get some reconstructive stuff done. And here's a little picture of Landon right here on the left, but he would always look for the white W9 coming on through here. While he was doing his rehab, so the bridge is blue today, looking beautiful. Kind of see it. That's the Jacksonville little. I call it a bay, but it's really a river. Right here, straight ahead is the catwalk walkway from building to building for that hospital. So he would always look for a white W9, and Yeah, Landon, I'm pretty doing good, buddy. I hope you're throwing some awesome strikes out there. And we're always thinking about you, man, you and the family. And Ken, Papa, thanks so much for sending us an update. And best of luck for you in this baseball season, buddy. And I'll do a little horn tune real quick for any other kids up there that might be lonely tonight or think about other things on that walkway. All right, buddy. Let's get down to Daytona. There you go, buddy. It's kind of alarming to see headlights pointing at you. Okay, they're cross-docking. So if you've never heard of cross-docking, normally there's a dock between the trucks. But one of those trucks must have broke down because there's two Penske box trucks backed up gate-to-gate or tailgate-to-tailgate. And they're probably just loading the stuff on the truck that is working, I guess. I don't know, but it's kind of crazy. You probably should turn your headlights off, especially the high beams, facing right in oncoming traffic. I was like, did somebody just spin out and crash, or what's going on? But that was scary for a second. All right, making good progress. Cruising 95 between Jacksonville and Daytona. Daytona Speedway right to our left. Oh, yeah, I love Daytona. It's not the... kind of the Myrtle Beach of Florida beaches, I would say. Just like a carnival fun boardwalk feel to it, but it's a cool place. I like the speedway, I like the vibe of it. It's not like a ritzy beach destination, but it's a good time. So that's Daytona, love it. Been there a couple times, teed up to the boys. Never been to the race though. I mean, I caught the end of the race last year. Daytona 500, but I'd like to actually go to the race. That would be fun. So we'll get that going. But right now, we're going to get going through Orlando. Luckily, it's the middle of the night, so we don't have too much traffic. Because Highway 4 can be a nightmare. Oh, my goodness. Here we go. Let's venture off towards the west. See you later, Daytona. 77 degrees. Get a little bit of jig break. I like how they had the sign lit up red, white, blue. That's kind of cool. 50 mile an hour exit. We're going about 55. We got someone passing us on the inside. There you go, little Honda. All right, let's get there. About 100 miles left. Hello, Orlando, in the middle of the night. I love it. No traffic. Keep rolling. All right, get past Disney World and we'll be fine. We have about 50 miles to go. Shut it down and I'll see you guys in the morning. Good morning, Florida. A crisp 82 degrees this morning. Oh yeah. And here's our left turn. Lakeside Station, okay. Nice little breeze. Extreme hip hop step class, okay. All right. 84 lumbers down here. That guy's turning. Nice Peterbilt, got big old pipes. Want some pipes like that on the K100. I'm thinking of just a single pipe. Like, why do I have to do dual pipes? Why not just have a single pipe? One single pipe and one single intake pipe. Can't see past your trailer. We're good, let's go. Let's boogie. End of this road, that's our drop. This place on the left says, tired of OTR? Drive for Star. Be home every night. Oh yeah, I love these trees. I love the Spanish moss. I don't know, you guys let me know. Is that a good company? You guys like it? Looks like a bunch of day cabs and they, I don't know what they move around. Those look like transformer boxes or something. Or air conditioner units, I don't know. But down here to the right, that's us, 2727 Henderson Way, I think, Henderson Parkway, I'm not sure. Look at the GPS, looks like a big old distribution center. There we are. Trucks this entrance, I would imagine, because there's a bunch of trailers on the side of the building. Oh, it's also part of Star, okay. Star Body Armor. Alright, it's a warehouse to hold this stuff. A let's give it to them. Find a gear. There you go. That says Sunoco, which is not where we're going. I'm looking inside there. They have a bunch of like bundles of cardboard boxes. That's not us. Let's look for Star, Body Armor Star. Where all these other trucks are, probably. I think so. My hat's a little dirty from that trailer. Steve Bass Motorsports trailer had a little bit of rust residue from getting underneath the cars and chaining them up, getting them all secured. There you go, driver check-in. I love it when they have giant signs. We're about 15 minutes early to our appointment. Timed it up just perfect. Let's get in there, get our bills, get checked in. So this whole QR code check-in thing, pretty cool. Just take pictures of your license, upload to be a picture of the DOL, and then they text you, ooh, it's windy. And like right back when I got back in the truck, they said door 60. So we're already checked in, let's get to door 60, get this off the truck, find something else.
This is door 40 with this first truck, so 20 more past him. And this guy kind of backed up, then he jumped out and checked. It's called Goal, Get Out and Look. So he did do that, which is awesome. And just doesn't want to hit anybody else's trucks, which is also awesome. We'll get into 60 once he's done. He's got plenty of room. Yep. So what he needs to do right now is get his truck more, it's called under it, more straight, so that his trailer doesn't swing into that truck next to him. And these newer trucks, so now he's gonna go forward. These newer trucks turn a lot better than the old W9, and their wheelbase is shorter, so they maneuver better. So if you do wanna come out here and get what they call a hood truck, a Peterbilt or a W9, it's gonna be a little harder to turn, but still doable. Just gotta get used to it. I think a classic XL, which is also considered a hood truck, has a little bit better turning radius, but I'm not sure. You guys let me know. I've never turned one. I've turned an FLD, but it was a day cab. So the shorter the wheelbase, the shorter the distance between those back two axles and the front axle, that's the wheelbase, the easier it is to maneuver the truck. So that's a Cascadia. I've heard those are pretty dang easy, but we're gonna have a little bit more of those trailers out there a little bit further up than they are back here. So hopefully we got some room to move. He did a good job. Let's go, door 60. I think this Volvo's actually in door 60. Oh no, we got one right next to him.
Okay. Which is nice because the trailer's not, there's no truck in front of that trailer, which makes it a little easier for this backup.
Let's do it.
Green APU is keeping us cool, but we've been in the door a little over an hour and they haven't even dropped the ramp, so. And everybody next to us haven't heard one truck leave, so I don't know what that means, but we're waiting. Okay. Got a little text message saying, come inside, get your paperwork, and then within 10 seconds, comes to my door and gives me my paperwork. So we're done. We're good. And that was, it took off like 2 pallets, and it sat there for 10 minutes, and like 5 minutes went by, and then I was done. So, awesome. We're done. We're unloaded. Let's get back towards Jacksonville, Savannah.
Turned into an absolutely beautiful day. 84 degrees. I don't know if that water is supposed to be there. That's just some extra runoff, but it looks like it's supposed to be there. But yeah, not too bad. Once they get you going, they unload it pretty quick. Once again, $3, like 80 cents a mile out of Florida, 75 cents a mile. All the way to Columbia for like $300, $400. I'm like, just like I always do, I'll head up to Jacksonville, look for loads, and head up to Savannah. But it's a little bit later, it's 11 o'clock now, so we might hit traffic going through Highway 4, because all times of the day, Disney World, it's showing red on the map already. And we'll see what that does for us, but let's get out of here, go find Highway 4, and get back on 95.
little bit of bad merging, and I can only imagine that that person's getting pulled over for some illegal driving or something, because you can't really go too fast. We're pretty stuck right here. Looks like a lady pleading her case with a handicap plaque right on the front of the car. Hopefully all goes well. T's and P's. All right. We got about 70 miles till Daytona, and then we head up 95. Gotta get through this first. Good old Disney World. Have Mickey's ears over there to the left, part of the power grid. And Disney World's right there on the left. Beautiful place. Taking all of my sons there on their fifth birthday. Not a huge fan of Disney anymore, but I grew up right down the street from Disneyland in Anaheim, California, south of Los Angeles a little bit. From the time I was I was born in Nebraska, Omaha, but when I was less than 1 year old, I drove on the floorboard of a C-10 Silverado, a little lift on it, from Omaha, Nebraska, over to Mission Viejo, California. That's where I lived from that age on, about 1 year old, just about 1 year old, till about 11, 12. I lived right there by Disneyland. So I had a special place in my heart. We had season passes. California residents could go for a lot cheaper, so my mom bought passes. I think it was kind of like babysitting for her. She would just drop us off and let us play for the day. It was pretty cool. So we knew that place like the back of our hand. We knew everything about it. But I wanted them all to kind of experience. So we did the traditional park, Magic Kingdom, because that's represented by the park that I grew up with. So each one of them went for their fifth birthday. We all stayed at the same resort. It was the Sands, or it was like a beach resort. They have all different themes for their resorts on Disney property, so it's a Disney property. But anyways, beautiful place. Took all three of them there. Very blessed to be able to do that. They don't remember it all the way. They do remember little bits and pieces, like the pool had sand in it, like real sand, and then we buried them, and all these different hot tubs. There's a pirate ship slide, so they remember some stuff about that. But of course, we got full videos of it, so they can watch it. Hopefully that'll bring back more memories for them. But that's my little thing about Disney World. Will I go back again? I don't know. Maybe sometime, but I like Dollywood a lot more. I love Dollywood. It's closer. It's right there above us in the Gatlinburg area, Smoky Mountains. So that's our go-to for amusement parks and kind of hanging out. Hopefully we can get up there this winter for either a fall Thanksgiving or a winter Christmas time. Just to be able to see the park again and decorate it so cool. And it's going to be a little harder to get up there. That's the only problem. A lot of those roads you take up there are not going to be done for probably 5 to 10 years. Before you can cruise up there easily again. So, peace and peace for everybody that lost everything up there. And you're always our thoughts, our prayers for rebooting and getting back on track of life. So, all right. But that is where Disney World is. And we're heading into downtown Orlando and then off to Daytona. We will see you later, Daytona Speedway. It's right over there. You can see the top of it. Oh, man. And Bucky's is right up here on the right. Cruising good. Just trying to find a load in Jacksonville. 82 degrees. Well, that is new to me right there. I just had an LED signs back there that popped up truck bypass, just like Georgia. So I've never seen that in Florida, but they just said bypass. I said, okay, I shall go. I must be able to tell that I'm empty. Got some infrared or something, or some, I don't know what they got, but somebody's in the old garage getting inspected. Got an RGM with a pretty big heavy piece of equipment over there. Nice reefer with a huge sleeper. All kinds of good stuff. Yeah, but they're working tonight. But yeah, I never seen a bypass. So coming out of Daytona, northbound 95, you could get the bypass. Save your brakes. Save some time, too. Stop at the truck rest area real quick. 27 spots that way, 5 spots this way. I'll take the 5 spots this way because it looks like there's more than 5. There's 5 right there. I'll turn the fan on, get a little stretch, and we'll look for some loads right here. Because we're kind of south of Jacksonville because you don't want to go through all of Jacksonville. And then, I was going to go over there, but I'll take this one. Have to backtrack, come back down here. So I said, yeah, let's go ahead and come on up here. All right.
So let's get on Truck Smarter and look for some loads. Why that oil cools down a little bit. But yeah, I just don't want to go through and have to come back to a load because we're just below the 285 loop around Jacksonville right now. Nice little rest area. Never been to this one, I don't think. Nice rest area, not bad at all. Oh, and my sons would love this. Oh yeah. My goodness, guys, you can't beat that Florida breeze and that sunshine. Woo, it's nice out here. Some nice wheels. Brand new tires. Okay, we got a load, guys. Sitting there and refreshed and got on load board. There was these couple loads that I saw earlier that nothing for wishing on those. They wouldn't go above 325. But Nolan had another one while I was on their load board. Kind of sent me from Truck Smarter to their load board. And they had one going to Myrtle Beach for 750. I said, hey, I can do that for 1,000. What's this guy doing? Got out of his truck? Just kind of sitting behind mine? I don't know. Maybe he's trying to pull in somewhere? Maybe he hit my trailer? Hope not. Maybe just looking to line up his spot. Anyways, we got it. I said $1,000. Supposed to pick up at 1 o'clock. It's almost 2 right now. I said I could be there about 3. And she said, get there as quick as you can. Yeah, no one hit our trailer, so we're good. I don't know what he's doing. All right, let's get out of here before somebody does. Go pick up our load. Myrtle Beach, let's go.
So a lot of times I like parking like behind a supermarket or Walmart or something, because sometimes these spots, guys might just get in trucks and leave real quick. If you don't time it just right, you're turning in and out, you clip someone's trailer real easy in here for over their bumper. So I like to be somewhere where there's less chance of that happening. Oh yeah. Turn and burn, let's get to the pickup. It's actually right off that 285 loop. We gotta go over the big bridge, come back down, and it's right there where 85 meets back up with it. No cars coming? Okay. Turn and burn. Oh, that clutch is doing good. If I was doing that before, I used to let go. Gotta walk away a little bit. I had to pull it back. Now it is strong. I think I'm getting better fuel mileage because of that also. I think it was slipping before just a little bit as I was going. Not sure. Maybe it's all in my head. But we're about 7.2 on average now. We used to be about 6.7. So yeah, maybe your clutch helps your fuel mileage. Go figure. A little bit of daunting clouds right here if they're coming to Jacksonville. I don't know if we're getting any rain or not, but looks like it. And then I was going to wash the truck, guys, after I get loaded right now. If I get loaded, I don't know if they're like hard cut off at 3 o'clock or 4 o'clock. I don't know what the appointment was for one. So that makes you feel like they probably were going at least till 3 to have a 2 hour load window. But anyways, I was gonna get loaded and wash it up in Brunswick at the good old Streaking Beacon. That has a bright blue house down there. But it's gonna rain tomorrow. It's a 90% chance of rain tomorrow. I'm like, dang it, man. Looks like we got some traffic up here. The map shows a little bit of yellow for slowing down, but not too bad. So let's just keep our distance and see what's going on. There are the Jacksonville ports, and it is about to go up on a Wednesday. She's choosing, something like that. Clear skies out to the right, like out to the ocean. But right here, gray skies to the left, and all those cranes pulling stuff off the ships. I don't know if there's going to be a mass influx of stuff coming into town or into the ports before tariffs get put on or something like that. That might be a good holiday season this winter leading into Christmas because people trying to get stuff in here and load up. I don't know. We're going to climb this bridge right here, come back down, and be really close to the top of Florida. There are some white caps down there, some swells coming in from all that wind. Even the St. John's River over there, when you get out of Orlando, you kind of pass a big area of it, it had all these ripples in it. Those are some big old swells. You can surf on those things. That's crazy down there. Man, okay.
Mother Nature tugboat down there. Way more powerful than we could ever imagine. But hey, grateful to live on beautiful Earth. Got a little concrete plant down there. I think they had an asphalt plant around here too, on the other side. And lots of containers, lots of rail, refinery, all kinds of stuff. We got 10 miles till we exit. They are making good progress on this whole construction, looks like, but just not there quite yet. Getting there. Should be nice when it's done. I don't know if Florida makes much progress. The S-curve of Savannah doesn't make much progress either, but oh yeah, we're 3 miles away. We go right back over 95, which is right below us. And then it's, I think, two exits right here. Second exit after we get over 95. I've ever come over this way on 95. I've always exited down there or exited going on and well, exited back to 95. First time for everything in trucking. Let's go. Turn apart. Let's drive them down and get past this truck. Because our next exit is 1 mile away. Past, what is that, Columbia? I think so, yeah. Some room to get over. There we go. Let's try and get some batteries on this truck. Here we go. Can't say I've ever exited here. This is almost where I bought a trailer. I don't know if you guys, I think it was 3 months ago, 4 months ago. It's been a while. I looked at a trailer down here. I was thinking about buying one. That one was, how much was that thing? 75, 85, 65? I don't remember how much it was. But it was not even close to as nice as the trailer I just bought for less money, less than all those prices. So maybe we'll grab another one this next couple of weeks, find something that pops up. I'd love to just have all the same trailers. That would be awesome. If I could find another Great Dane, aluminum roof, composite walls. Within the time, mine's a 2015 that we're pulling right here. If I could find like 2010 to 2018, that'd be awesome. Just like the other one I just got. All right, so our ignition drive, this is gonna be our first ride, it looks like, is where we're going. And we'll just pray that they're in a good mood, they stay up until 5. As if they have any problems, they're like, hey, come back tomorrow. I'll just deadhead up to Savannah. But if this one works, it works. It's $1,000 for 300 miles, I'll take it out of Florida. Way better than $300 for 600 miles. My goodness. All right, so this is a, what's it called? An ignition drive. All right. This is right by where I looked at that trailer, by the way. That's why I said that. Like, somewhere around here, there's a yard that people park their trucks and their trailers at, and that's where I looked at it. Looks like that's awesome. They skipped that traffic right there. Beautiful. Yeah, I've never been down here before. It's the second building. It's the last one, 2895. Drop down to 75 degrees. Looks like they're working, though. Navigation dots, like, at the very end of this street, so. 2895. 2895. That's 28. That's 2619. Marcon. That's a nice Mustang over there. I still can't get over how fast that 2SS 2017 Camaro is. My goodness. That thing is a rocket. I know it's got some tune to it and bigger headers, Texas Speed cam in it, stuff like that. Better coils, all that. I don't even know if it has better fuel power or more fuel injection in it. Bigger fuel injectors, I don't know, but it's definitely raspy. Okay, is it this one or the back one? I think it's the back one because it's Interstate Batteries and there's a bunch of green back there. That's the color of Interstate Batteries. That's gotta be it. Yep, Interstate. All right, bunch of cars there, so people still working. I don't think I've ever delivered to Myrtle Beach. I've seen plenty of loads there. They've always been pretty cheap. I imagine it's just
side. I don't know. Doesn't have any signs saying pickup, delivery. So I'm going to pull in here and hope I don't get yelled at. Yeah, down there is a sign for no trucks, so it's got to be here. Nice Corvette.
It's the Corvette Cletus McFarland started his YouTube channel with.
Beautiful. Okay, let's check in.
I hit that button,
and it just beeped a couple times, and then the gate opened. So there's another whole thing of buttons right here, too, but that must be for after hours. I don't know. We're clocking in. But that gate opened, so we'll come on in, and we'll look for where we check in at. Just trying to stay out of the way in case these guys are leaving anytime soon. Let's see. We got one container. That guy's leaving. Door right there, but it doesn't say like driver check-in. Clarios powering 1 in 3 cars worldwide. Okay, I never heard of a Clarios battery. Yeah, I don't know. Well, let's go ahead and park this big girl and get out of the way and see. Yeah, all the doors don't have any writing on them. I don't know, but all the cars are parked down there, so I imagine it's over there. We will see. Just got to cruise down. There's one car parked there. Okay, shipping and receiving. Bam, bingo. Bajingo, bingo. Park this truck out of the way. We'll use this little area right here. Windy out here. Nose up here and then back it in there, because then that let us have a good back angle instead of a blind side. And let's go check in. Interstate batteries.
How you doing?
Are you being picked up?
Shipping. Yeah, I'm picking up. Going to Myrtle Beach. They gave me the load. I was still like in Orlando. I'm like, I could try to get up there.
What's your trailer number?
Well, I was scared for a second because she's like, oh, you're definitely not getting loaded. I said, I missed my appointment from 1 o'clock. Or she said, you're definitely not getting unloaded. I said, okay. and she's like, wait, are you picking up? I'm like, yeah, I'm going to Myrtle Beach. She's like, okay, what's your R number? And all I have is like an 8086 number. She's like, not that one. So pulled up a Raycon and she's like, there it is right there. And she found it. She's like, okay, getting door 135. I think she said something like that. So I had to ask her again. I forgot what she said. 115, 112. Something like that. Let's see if we have enough room to open up the doors.
Yeah, it's windy out here. Woo! Water everywhere.
Don't forget. I saw that. Awesome, awesome. Went live for a little bit. Got my paperwork and loaded real quick. Grateful for that because I'm 2 hours past the appointment time. Sun's popping out. Beautiful. And it is windy still. Let's get some food, relax. We're going to stay south of Savannah until the traffic subsides. And then we'll go ahead and head on up to Myrtle Beach. Well then, we have a ton of batteries. Okay, let's strap that down and get going.
Yeah, quite the obstructions right here. We got a nice little camera that's kind of right there in your way. And then we have some trucks that are, I don't know if it's getting cleaned or what's going on with. Oh, we got a truck there talking to some buddies. Be able to make it out of here, no problem. Just gotta be careful not to turn too quick. All right, get our trucks moving. I wonder where all this water came from. They might be washing that truck or something. I wonder if I gotta go back there and push the button. Let's see. Well, there we go. Jump down and push the button, and it opened. Let's get out of Florida, up into Georgia. All right, truck's leaving. We got here just in time for people around here. It's about 4 o'clock now and people are leaving. Just in time. Thank you for the load. Appreciate it. Truck smarter for the win. So we can clear this guy. Okay, he's unloading some recycled batteries. I don't know if I'm going to clear his truck without hitting this thing right here. We should be able to get right by. It's going to be close. Yeah, we got about a foot clearance on that pole back there. We got it. Get out of here. These guys are folding some tarps. You guys that do flatbed, man, I applaud you guys. That is some work right there. That is how you stay in shape. flatbed guys rule. There's only two of them, but you never know where they could be their buddies at. Watch out, guys.
Canadian Air Force.
Come on, guys. We dropped a 35. And somebody was smoking their brakes. You can smell that brake residue. My goodness. What do we got? We got green. Oh, green. Pull me in. Okay. Man, that guy was smoking them. Smoke. Smell them all the way over here. Now we dropped a 20. We're at 25. Stay on the left side. Let's get up there to the skate. Pull on nice and gentle. Pull off nice and gentle. Give a wave. We're good to go. Okay. It's been fun, Florida. Let's get to Georgia. We'll see you later, Florida. Thanks for having us. Just got off the phone with my buddy from CH Robinson, and he has a load from Charlotte back to right where I live, right where I parked my truck. For Friday, straight through, pick it up, take it by, drop it off. That's Casey's birthday. Casey's actual birthday party is not till Saturday, but I want to be there for his birthday. I'll take him out a little one-on-one time, go get him lunch, special day for him. He does have school that morning. I'd like to take him to school, but gotta make some money out here, you know, gotta pay the bills, just per se, which we don't have many of, but still gotta pay them. I don't want to waste too much time deadheading, so that's what I'm saying. So I'm going to try and find something from the Myrtle Beach area to Charlotte, delivering Friday morning, and then that'll just set me up to pick up that, shoot it straight through Friday, and be done with it, be home for the weekend. So that'd be a ideal world, but I'm going to stop here, refresh out of Florida, and look for something out of Myrtle for tomorrow real quick, and yeah. Let's do that real quick. At exit one. T-Dubs one time saved a turtle. It was in the middle of the road right here at this intersection. We were in the truck. I think we were in the Volvo. She jumped out and brought him over here to these little bushes and put him in here to the right. Oh, yeah. Not too heavy a load. You can feel it behind you, but not all maxed out, 40,000. But they're doing kind of like a remodel to this. I thought it was pretty nice before. Like, it was done up pretty good, but I guess they wanted to change it again. Because it is getting redone again, so we'll get out of the way, park over here, and refresh, look for a load. So I found a load, but it is a broker I've never worked with, and they wanted to set me up with the company, but it doesn't have like an electronic setup. It has like a, what's it called? Beautiful sunset coming up. Like a real carry packet, like I have to fill it out. So I don't have a printer here. So my phone lets me like autofill, but all the little places where you have to sign or like check the box for escort for your company, you have to go over like a little pen and like draw with your finger. So at some certain place I'd like print, that's a small little FedEx on pole one. Certain place you had to like print your name and stuff, and I'm using my finger. It looks like a third grader's drawing it, or a second grader. So I sent it back to him all filled out. We'll see if he accepts it. But he's got one going from right there by Myrtle to Charlotte, Salisbury. So well, that might be a good one. This person was right in front of me, the horse trailer at the agricultural station. They're probably empty because they just rolled right through. Anyways, we'll see if we get that one. And go in here and refresh real quick. So I guess they just kind of rearranged it a little bit. Still kind of the same setup, but they're doing all kinds of different stuff. So. Not there yet, though. A lot of wide open space. Like right here. What a beautiful sunset. So, I don't know if we're gonna get that. No response from the broker, but it's 5 o'clock, so they probably went home. But I did fill out the packet manually. So pretty. 5 o'clock, we start running up 95 now. We'll be fine again through Savannah. So we'll do that and get reset, get to Myrtle Beach. A couple other loads I'm looking at. Going back to Charlotte, just trying to get back there to make it work so I can get that other load going home. Yeah, and I asked him if he could load early tomorrow. He said he'll let me know in the morning. Because if I don't find anything, I'll just deadhead to Charlotte
pick that up, go home, deliver it in the morning on Friday, be done with it. So we'll figure it out. Either way, got some options. What a beautiful sunset. God's grace. Beautiful. Okay, let's get back in this thing.
There is the streaking beacon. Just can't do it because 90% chance of rain tomorrow. Be worthless. Get right dirty again. So, all right, we'll keep moving on and we'll get you washed eventually, big old girl. Gotta watch your speeding out there, guys, especially through here from Florida state line, Florida Georgia line up till about 50 miles in. There's a lot of presence. Keep it good all the time, but extra good right around here. The trooper just pulled over and turned the lights on. I didn't see anybody on the bridge or anything. I don't know what he's doing, but he's staying on the bridge. Hopefully there's nobody on it. We're gonna close this video up, guys. We get to Savannah. Then I'll run through South Carolina tonight, get up to Myrtle Beach area. We made it back to South Carolina. Come on and raise up. That car hauler is flying. My goodness. We'll stop up here and exit. What is it? Exit 5 as a pilot? Or exit 8? I think it's exit 5. Exit 5. Exit 5 as a pilot. Stop there. Close this video. Just kind of check for any loads for tomorrow. Again, something might have popped up. Somebody might have listed something. Uber has one, but it's real cheap. It's like $360 for a heavy water load going to Charlotte. So, I don't know. We'll see if we find anything else, and we'll close this video and keep rolling to Myrtle Beach. I'm not really sure what the Cascadia is doing here. If he's backing up or what. Alright, he just waved at me to go past him, but what he's trying to do here. But I'll just go ahead and get out of here. There's a bunch of marks on his trailer, probably from taking out some other people. But we'd like to get past him before we get some marks on our trailer. Alright, I like this pilot. It's pretty nice. I think this one has a Taco Bell in it, but I'm not hungry. Good old authentic Mexican food. But yeah, I'm going to shut it down for a second here. I don't know what that guy's doing in the back of his trailer. What kinds of weirdness going on around here tonight? Let's just get in and out, close this video, and pray for something to work, because I really want to be able to take care of my broker buddy's load, but at the same time, if it doesn't work and it's just making me deadhead or something, I'm not going to worry about it, you know? So, we'll see what we got going on.
But on that note, nice meeting you tonight, Grant. He came up and said, man, I watch all your shows. God bless you guys. Enjoy your route, dude. He works for CVS. Does not do the same thing every day, but he does run around. But it was awesome meeting you, man. Thanks for watching. We're going to hopefully get that 50-50 paid. Cross your fingers. Hold your hearts for me. I'm sure they will, but it's hard to have someone have a 49 credit score, and then you're the one chasing the money. Just like that's what factoring is. Factoring is for you. And not have to chase the money. These factor people get to do it for you, and they take a small percentage. So that's day and age today. Hopefully that'll change soon enough, and we'll be able to use factoring again with everybody. Everybody have a good credit score, and we'll be back to business. But yeah, like I said, on that note, God bless you. Grant, awesome meeting you today, and we'll see you on the next one. Nice classic. Bye, guys.